What's up everybody? In today's video, we're going to go over a couple of Robin builds that I personally like to play, and the techniques I utilize to maximize my chances of winning each and every game. So let's jump into it. So the two builds we're going to go over today are what I like to call the short range Robin and the sniper Robin. Now, there is a third melee Robin build, but to be honest, it's not very good, so we're just going to kind of gloss over that for now and act like it just doesn't exist. So the first build we're going to go over is the short range Robin build. Now the three perks we're going to want to use for this is Volatile Gourd, Broadhead, and Mercurial Arrow. Now Volatile Gourd is going to increase our gear capacity, which means we get two flashbangs, which is two forms of disengagement for when a character gets up on us, which is something we do not want with this build. And that's because of our second perk, Broadhead, which not only decreases our range, but makes our quick shots very ineffective. We're going to want to use our mid-range and charge shots and be hitting characters like Johns and Tooks in the back and not necessarily confront them directly. And then our third perk is Mercurial Arrow. Much like Volatile Gourd, it is a means to get someone off of you in the close combat situations where you're not going to win in any other scenario. The only hope is to either ultimate them and kill them instantly or flashbang and run like hell. So the way you're going to want to utilize this build is to soften up targets for your teammates. You're going to get some kills, but your main objective is to get these guys low as they're coming into the fight or in the middle of the fight from a safe distance. You can't fight anyone in melee range. Maybe another Robin is the only hope that you have of winning in melee, so you want to disengage from those situations immediately. Your Volatile Gourd and Mercurial Arrow are going to be essential to this, so make sure you're not wasting your flashbangs all over the place and wait until someone's running at you to flashbang and then reposition or work in tandem with a teammate to assassinate that person quickly and move on. The range falloff from Broadhead is pretty substantial, so even perching above is going to be difficult to get those shots, so you're going to be on the ground level with everyone else. But again, using Volatile Gourd and Mercurial Arrow to get those melee characters off you and kind of just be an annoying pest is how you play this build. This build is great, I personally think, for someone that's not the greatest at hitting heads. You want to play Robin, you love it, but you know your headshots aren't always there. Play this Broadhead build, because even if you're not hitting headshots, if you're fully charged body-shotting people like John, Took, Marianne as they're coming into the fight, most of the time they're going to be one hit for your teammate, which is huge. Not only will it make them play differently from not being able to have a full health pull, they're scared going in, but your teammates are going to feel overconfident and be able to, you know, easily dispatch them with just a light attack or so. It makes the whole fight, as they're even just coming in, super scary for them. So try and stay in that medium range and really soften up the targets for your teammates. The other build we have available to us is our Sniper Robin build. Now the three perks we're going to want to use with this are Focused Flight, Bodkin Point, and Elemental Arrow. Now Focused Flight is going to give us our long shot kill to build our ability meter faster. So this is going to mean we're going to hopefully have tons of Elemental Arrows to spam at our enemy during the game. Bodkin Point is going to charge our arrow speed and range, but our arrows are going to break, which is not really a big deal. This is going to mean we can shoot at a super high range. The only caveat to that is that we are going to be required to hit headshots to actually kill people. So if you're good at clicking heads, this is going to be the build for you. And then finally, Elemental Arrow. Our arrow is going to explode after a shorter duration, but unlike Mercurial Arrow, it's not going to have the range fall off, which means that we can shoot this in tandem with Bodkin Point extremely far and extremely accurate. So if you haven't guessed it, we're going to be playing the Sniper Robin build as a classic sniper. Now we're going to be looking for high ledges and towers to sit on and snipe down on top of the enemies and provide our team with assistance. This is going to provide us two benefits. First, obviously we're safe, we're way away from the fight, and it's going to take time for any melee or Marianne characters to come and deal with us. And secondly, if we can't hit the shots, we're at least tagging our enemies and allowing our team to see them as they come in. But essentially with this build, you need to be hitting the headshots to make it worth. If you're not getting headshot kills, you're not going to utilize this build to the fullest. Now, what we're not going to do, and something I see all too often, is sitting in one spot, getting this really good angle, and you're just sitting on it. And then eventually someone's going to get wise to what you're doing and come and assassinate you. And then you go back and they assassinate you again. And before long, you become useless. We need two or three spots in kind of each area that they might not all be the best angle, but that we can rotate through to keep the melee and Marianne's guessing on where we are. This allows you to reposition and waste a lot of the enemy's time just inadvertently. When they go to flank the spot that you were at that you frustrated and headshot them from so far away from, and you're not there, they just wasted all that time. Now they still have to waste more time to go back to the fight or try and find you again. So you're inadvertently wasting one to two characters' time. You're hopefully killing another one to two characters just with headshots. And then because of focused flight, you have your elemental arrow on, you know, pretty much command. Bodkin Point is also going to make it so that your elemental arrow has as much range as a normal arrow does. It gets the benefits from Bodkin Point. So you can also rain down bombs at will almost. If you can get one long shot kill of about 600 points, which isn't crazy hard with this build, that's almost a full ult. So if you are, you know, positioned perfectly, one to two kills, ult the next guy. One to two kills, ult the next guy. You're going to be raining death down like nobody's business. You're going to be the scariest person on the battlefield by far. But it's important to reposition, not let yourself be an easy target, and hit those headshots. That's some of the most important stuff that we got to do with this build. The matchups for Robin are fairly straightforward and pretty simple compared to most of the other classes that have some nuances to them. John, Took, and Marianne, all three of these characters, if they have gotten close to you, you need to run away or kill them instantly with your ultimate. So you have no realistic chance of beating any of these three characters in a close fight as Robin, and you're not expected to. Your close range capabilities are abysmal. You either need to disengage with your consumable or by, outplaying them, running to a teammate, or kill them immediately with your ultimate, your elemental arrow. Even if you kill them, regardless of what happens, you get away or you kill them or they kill you, you need to reposition. That spot is done for a minute. They are going to know that you like this spot at this point, and they're going to be watching it even if they're not right on top of it. So now you need a new spot. You need to do that, what we said before, reposition, get to another spot, do some damage, and this time reposition before they kill you. You know, I have a rule, 3 to 4 kills, switch spots. The team has all been hit by you. They all have a chance to have clicked the gears in their head and said, I'm not going to let that happen again. I'm going to go deal with that Robin. So 3 to 4 kills, reposition. Now, with another Robin, it's a little different. It's obviously a mirror matchup, so dodging, a melee and meleeing back is just going to be standard. And then you're going to have the dodge, shoot, dodge thing, which, you know, is a classic Marianne type fight. But most of the time I found that it's not even worth your time. Just disengage anyway. That Robin is probably not going to do much because you know where he is if he tries to take your perch. You can easily counter, you know, snipe him, or he just follows you and kind of wastes his time for a little bit until you can get a teammate to help. The time that you waste fighting him, even if you win, is usually, you know, you turn around and look and then your whole team is dead. So most matchups, if anyone gets close, especially with a sniper build, you are just leaving the area completely and trying to reposition and get a good spot where you can headshot people. Thanks so much for watching, guys. If you have any questions or thoughts on the video, please feel free to leave them in the comments section below, and I'll see you all in the next one. Peace!